Welcome back to GoJacks.com and our weekly update with the head football coach, John Stiegelmeier. And it feels like there's a little bit of deja vu all over again, because a week ago we talked about your season opener on Saturday, and yet we're going to do it again. Before we discuss that, just one of the more unique situations I would envision you've ever had in coaching college football on Saturday. You go to Ames, Iowa, you get 4 minutes and 5 seconds of game action in, sit around for 2.5 hours, then get told to go home. There's no more game.
It was unique, and you know, you had that that hope we were going to be able to play. You know, every time lightning strikes, you have a 30-minute window, you wait, and we kept getting that, so it was like they were dangling it out there. But you know what? They made the right decision. Safety first, and as we were leaving town, the weather really got bad, so we were glad the decision was made.
Yeah, it didn't get any better at Ames, there's no question. Out of curiosity, what does the team do in the locker room? What are you coaches doing? How are you killing all this time with all these guys in obviously a very enclosed space?
Well, initially, you know, we thought we were going out in a little while. So initially we went over all the adjustments the few things we saw, and then we just tried to keep them busy. And then after a while, you know, we got them some snacks because it was going to be a long time. And after a while, it just kind of loosened up, and we're just hoping to have a decision made.
So you get the decision made that you are not going to finish this football game. You come back. How has that changed things in your preparation for this week, if at all, because you didn't really play much of a game?
Well, the only thing that really changes is you don't have that game to evaluate yourself, you know, to build on. But we do the same thing with practice film. So we're going to focus on Montana State and move ahead.
Was there much you could take out of the first 4 minutes and 5 seconds of the year that ended up not happening officially?
Not really. No, we're going to adjust a little bit differently to one of the formations we saw and make that universal. But we had talked about that, so that's really the only thing that happened.
Well, you have an 11-game regular season this year with a bye built in. Iowa State's bye is a different week than South Dakota State, so it doesn't work without changing roughly every schedule in all of college football to possibly make it up with Iowa State. But do you want to try to get another game in? Are you happy with 10? What's the philosophy?
Well, as I walked in the locker room and knew that we had lost that game, there's one thing that was in my mind, and that was our seniors. You know, and the guys work hard for every rep, and there's a lot of reps in every game. And so I hope we can find something for those guys. It'd be very, very tough, I know that. But our program has been built by seniors, and that's my hope.
All right, and with that, any changes this week with the practice schedule or whatnot because of the fact that you only got a few minutes in Saturday?
We're going to practice a little bit Monday night. Normally you spend most of your time on last week's film, and so we're going to be a little ahead, but you still have to game plan, and that takes a lot of time. So we'll have a few things in for Monday.
Let's talk about the opposition coming up on Saturday in the Dairy Drive, Montana State. This is a Bobcat team that is talented, coming off a win over Western Illinois on Thursday to open the season. And with a shift at quarterback kind of late in the game, had to decide what they were going to do with their expected quarterback not available. They go to Troy Anderson, a tremendous talent who is a run-pass threat. And he had the ball in his hands, either throwing it or running it for, I think, every snap but 12 they had on Thursday against Western Illinois. And he's a heck of an athlete.
I respect their coaching staff, first of all, because they took what looked like going to be a really tough situation and found the guy to make it as good as it can be. And he's a special player. He's a great runner. Surprised us with his ability to throw because it's not his natural position. And really what it is, it's a kind of a hybrid wildcat. That's what people relate to with a guy that's a better thrower.
And when you look at all the weapons they have offensively, he's got a lot of pieces around him. It's not just a one-man show.
No, he's got they're a good football team, and Montana State's had a history of being a good football program. The line is solid. The receivers, tight ends are good, but it all starts with him.
Defensively, a couple of FBS transfers have come in, guys like Fa'anono on the front, and they really played well in the second half because they were down double digits to Western Illinois and rallied to win. That defense played very well as the game went along last Thursday.
They did, and they got a couple turnovers, which are huge plays in a football game. They rose up when they needed to. Western missed a field goal, and so all those things come into play. There's never one reason, but they're up front. Their up front is really, really good. Their two defensive ends are really special players, so we're going to have our work cut out for us.
speaking of FBS transfers, they have one at kicker as well who made a couple of huge field goals for them. You already documented Western missed one. That was a big difference in the football game, and you know all too well that having special kickers can swing a game one way or the other.
Yeah, and not only did he make, I think, four in the game, he made one a mayday situation at the end of the first half where the pressure was really on. So a talented guy, and I'm sure they're feeling good about their kicking game.
It's the home opener for you on Saturday to get to play again at Dana J. Dykhouse Stadium. It's something that I know you really appreciate, and so does that locker room.
We do, and you know, the beautiful surroundings, you know, the more people you put in it, the nicer it gets. But we like to play at home. We like to honor the ag industry with the Dairy Drive, and so we're looking forward to it.
Mentioned my next point, the Dairy Drive. We've been at this for a few years now, and what a wonderful event to honor so many folks that make a significant impact not only on the economy of South Dakota, but specifically on South Dakota State University.
Yeah, I mean, again, we're a state that is grounded in agriculture. Obviously, we're a land-grant university. I've got a neat relationship with the dairy people here on campus. We're connected in a unique way, so excited to be part of that.
And all this odd stuff that happened here on Saturday in Ames, Iowa, now it's all behind you, right?
Yeah, we play in the present. That's one of the coolest things about our program. Whether it's a play in the football field or an incident, out of football, whatever, we deal with it and then we move on. And I think we grow that way.